So there it is. That wraps up the electrical for the south wall. Next episode is the range. So what is makeup air? It's essentially the outside air re-entering the house to make up for the air that got pushed out. If you don't allow for this, then that negative pressure buildup can create a vacuum, which can cause anything from the fan itself failing to backdrafting that can lead to a bunch of other bad stuff. So, to neutralize the negative pressure, you're going to need an opening. Now, theoretically, if your exhausting vent is 10 inches in diameter, you just need an opening that's 10 inches, and that should solve everything. Except that it doesn't, because the air leaving is forced out, let's say at 400 CFM, while the air entering is passive. And passive air cannot enter fast enough to match the pressure. In fact, passive air will not enter at all, unless there's a negative pressure to begin with that draws it in. So, basically, if you're going to force it out at 400, then you got to bring it in at 400, which means a matching motor, a damper, and maybe a heater, depending on where you live, all synced up to the exhausting hood. For an equivalent passive system, you need to have a much larger intake, around 4.5 times bigger, or just multiples of the small ones. But this is highly unrealistic. Nobody wants a 25-inch hole in the wall, or even many small ones. And all of this also needs to be hooked up to a damper that is synced to the range hood. A couple of other notes is that the location of this passive intake does matter. The closer it is, the better. And the minimum distance between the intake and the exhaust needs to be at least 3 meters apart. So, lots of things to consider. The hood came today from Victory Range Hoods. They're actually local down in Port Coquitlam. This is their 36-inch Typhoon model. It's actually 34 inches by 19.5 because it's an insert type. It's a very robust and sturdy build. Comes standard with an 8-inch top vent, which I upgraded to a 10-inch back vent. A 1200 CFM blower with 4 settings, baffle filters, and mechanical rotary switches because I didn't want anything that beeps or sings or is touch or auto sensing or Wi-Fi connecting. And here's the motorized damper. This is a power to open. So normally it's closed. When you switch it on, that's when it opens. This is the 35-inch per pound motor, and it takes about 45 seconds to fully open or close. This is the lift mechanism here. And the opening measures 10 inches by 8. And this is the current sensing switch. So unlike the damper, which is normally closed, this switch is normally open. So this motor has 4 settings. Just for this test, I'm going to hook up speed 2 and 3 through the current sensor switch. And this is so I can use 1 and 4 as the control. I don't want the system to activate the instant I turn on the hood. The black stays, the rest need to come off. Transformer, current sensing switch, motorized damper, the hood, and the wall cap pointing out the window are the participants for this test. So here I'm putting the wires for setting 2 and 3 through the current sensing switch. And I'm chopping off one end of a spare power cord to hook it up to the primary of the transformer so I can plug it in for testing. For the actual installation, the transformer will be tied into the same feed that powers the range hood. This is just a class 2 transformer, 24 volts, 60 hertz. Some stranded wires from an old broken lamp connected to the secondary. So this is one of the secondary. It's going to the damper. this is the other. And I'm going to split this into two. And one goes to the damper, other one to the current sensing switch. And then a connection back to the damper. So there's the power cord that I chopped off. Now connect it to the transformer. One of the secondary goes to the damper setting one. The other secondary splits into two. One half goes to the damper setting two, while the other goes to the current sensing switch, which is normally open or off, I should say. Once it senses current in one of the wires that it surrounds, it bridges the gap and completes the circuit to the damper, to setting three. So everyone passed the test. Makeup Air system is good to go. Next episode is going to be the actual installation, where I punch through the wall, make all the necessary mods, and get everything hooked up. Until then, that's about that.